Let's start putting some components on the Grasshopper canvas. I'd like to start with the most basic topological element we're going to be using, a point. I'm going to construct a point. I'm going to go to vector, point, and construct point. Okay, once I add that to the canvas, you'll notice that a few things change. First of all, I don't have that text that said add a component to the canvas anymore because, well, I have something there. Secondly, I have a couple of things down here. These are UI widgets, different elements that add information or help us out. Over here, we have the compass, which is allowing us to see where we have components on the canvas in case we had lost. And down here, we have a bar that essentially predicts the next component you want to use. This learns your behavior over time, and eventually it'll give you some suggestions of, well, after you use point, you also typically used a panel or something else. If you like to use them, you can keep them on. If not, you can always turn them off in display canvas widgets. For now, I'm going to leave them on. All right, let's look at our component here. As you can see, we have a set of inputs and an output. In the center, we have a description of the component itself. And the PT is the nickname or the short name for the component. This one is construct point. Some people, when they're working, prefer to actually see an icon instead of the text representation, for example, like the icon we had here. And this you can switch back and forth in display, draw icons. I actually prefer to work this way when I'm just working on something like this, but for teaching, I've noticed that the text representation is a little bit better. It helps you to find what component I'm actually using. Eventually, we might switch to kind of a hybrid mode, and this will be later down the line. Let's try to read the component. So if we look at the inputs here and we hover over, the first input here tells me that it's the x-coordinate. And most importantly is this little icon, this hexagonal icon that's 0.1. That's the icon for a number. And for the most part, the inputs will always hint at what they need. They're going to give you this icon. And that way, once you start using Grasshopper, you're going to recognize what kind of data the component's going to need. The output is similar. If I hover over the output, you'll notice that I get another icon, and this is the icon for a point. I guess we'd expect the construct point component to construct a point, and well, it does. In this case, notice that the component is whitish. This means that the component has everything it needs to actually calculate and complete its function. And if you notice, when you select this, you also see a kind of an X in the Rhino viewport. This means that the component has an X, Y, and Z coordinate, and it's drawn a point at the origin because X is 0, Y is 0, and Z is 0. If I right-click in the center, we're going to get a context menu that talks about some of the elements and some of the things that we can do with this. If I, for example, did not want to show the point, I can select on preview, and the point will go away from the Rhino viewport. This is similar to the hide command in Rhino. But notice that the component turns gray. Okay, it's just telling us that Grasshopper is calculating the geometry, but it's not showing it. If I right-click again, I can also choose Enabled to actually disable the component. Now Grasshopper is not actually calculating the geometry here. If we had data flowing through this component, the data would stop flowing here. There would be nothing coming out. You can see this is empty. This is helpful when you have definitions that maybe take a little bit of time to calculate, and you don't want it to calculate every time you switch something. Let's go and enable it again, and let's go and turn the preview on again. The component is changing colors depending on what we're doing, either by selecting it, or if we're hiding it, or disabling it. There are a few other context menus here. For example, if we right-click on X, we see that we have ways of modifying the inputs, setting the number, and doing a few other things. For example, let's set the number here to 10 and press Commit Changes. Now, our point is at 10, 0, 0. To summarize, we have all sorts of information about the component just by hovering over the different parts, and we can access ways to modify things by right-clicking on the inputs, right-clicking on the center, and right-clicking on the output. Let's see if we can apply this knowledge to something else. I'm going to go to vector point and distance and bring that to the canvas. See, that's not too hard. The distance component is orange. That's different. Essentially, what it's telling me is that something's wrong. It might be able to calculate something, but for the most part, it's not happy with the state that it's in. In this case, we can go over to this little balloon, click on it, and see what's wrong. There are two issues here. Input parameter A failed to collect data, and input parameter B failed to collect data. That's just a fancy way of saying, I don't know which points you want me to calculate the distance for. I need some information here. We need to feed it with some information. Let's go ahead and make this connection. And we'll talk about making and breaking connections in another video, but as you can see, it's pretty easy to do. We'll just click from here to here, connecting point, to A. If I hover over the inputs, you notice that, again, the inputs give you a hint of what it wants. The distance component wants to calculate the distance between two points, and here, effectively, it's giving me that icon for the point. And you can probably guess that out of B, you also need to get and connect a point there. The result of this is going to be a number, the distance of point A to point B. All right, so right now, we've solved one of the issues. We've given it an input in A, but we still have the issue with input in B. Let's go ahead and create another point. I'm going to go to vector point and construct point. This one, again, defaults to 0, 0, 0. Let's go ahead and connect that to B. All right, notice that the component went from being orange to being white. That means that it has everything it needs to calculate. And indeed, if we look at the output, we see this 10. 10 units from point A to point B. Fantastic. Now there's one more state that a component can have, and that's an all-out error. Could be several things. First of all, for example, that it's not getting the right kind of data, that it's taking too long to calculate. There's all sorts of things that could potentially go wrong. Typically, it's when you don't give a component the proper data. So let's see if we can make a component do that. If we go to vector point, let's just bring down a distance again. And here we remember that the distance is asking us for two points. But what happens if we connect a number there? For example, the result of distance. Now we have an error. The component is red. It's angry. It doesn't understand what you've given it, and it's going to say, no way, I'm not going to calculate. So let's look at the bubble here, and we get an error, says data conversion failed from number to point. It doesn't know how to convert a number to a point. It's not going to assume that number creates a point. There are some other data conversions that Grasshopper does on the fly, but in this case, it's not going to make that assumption for you. It's going to throw an error. The component turns red. Now, this was a bit of a no-nonsense example, but now you know that a red component means it's an error. An orange component probably means that there's a warning, something wrong, but more likely, it means that it doesn't have information. Let's go ahead and delete this one. There we go. Just a quick summary. Inputs will give us a hint of what we need to input. Outputs will give us a hint of the result. We right-click on all the areas of the component to get different context menus. Components that are orange need information. Components that are red are errors.